Hi Capricorn, thanks again for liking, sharing, subscribing. Okay, Eight of Wands, Three of Swords. Okay, Seven of Wands, Ten of Swords, Two of Pentacles, and the World card. Okay, starting off from the top left, we have the Eight of Wands. The Eight of Wands is all about news, action, movement, and communication. Now, this could be a strong fire sign that's around you or someone that's trying to communicate with you. If this is regarding a love situation, I feel as though there's a lot of communication. This could be a lot of texting, a lot of phone calls, a lot of emails that are happening back and forth with this person. I feel for some of you, not all of you, you may be dealing with two different people here. There could be a lot of offers around you, and you're sort of it's sort of a juggling act for you this month, Capricorn, because you do have the Three of Swords. The Three of Swords is having choices, being in a third party situation, having a lot of options in love, being conflicted which person to choose, and you also have the Two of Pentacles. So there's definitely two people that are around you or two things that you're juggling. So you're either juggling two relationships, two different people, a work in a relationship, a creative pursuit and a hobby, etc. So there's a lot of things that are happening around you, but especially in the love situation, I feel as though you're communicating with both. Now, one of them might open up and say to you that they've been involved in a third party situation, or they currently have an ex or someone that is around them. And this may cause you to become a little bit defensive, possessive, or jealous here with the Seven of Wands. So this is a possibility, but there's a lot of, I feel like there's a lot of communication. This person could be foreign. You could have met them on travels, or perhaps met them while they were traveling to your city. Now, if this is regarding a work situation, I feel as though there's a lot of correspondence that's going to be happening around you. Now, I'm not sure if someone's leaving the role or someone in a particular division is taking time off, and as a result, you're going to have to take on a more strenuous workload, or you're going to have to initiate and maintain communication on their behalf. But there's going to be a lot of people that will be trying to communicate with and through you. So you're sort of maybe representing this person perhaps as the Eight of Wands. This is also synchronicity, signs from the universe that are happening around you. Maybe it's signs regarding a lover. Maybe this is signs regarding a workplace, but there's things that are going to, that you're going to piece together that will slowly make sense. I also feel like this is steps to take. This could even be travel plans. You may hear of travel opportunities, or a friend or a partner or even yourself that's planning to travel, or offers of travel coming in. You might see them online through the web and think, oh, that's a great deal. I'm going to take that on board. So it's also a possibility here for you, Capricorn. Now, moving on, you have the Three of Swords. Now, the Three of Swords is conflict in love. It's disorientation, it's pain, it's heartache, it's a third party situation. It could be cheating, it could be deceit. Maybe this month you might find out that someone's been deceiving you, or someone special around you has been deceived in the past. They may open up to this and let you know. This is also about reliving a heartache, or hearing from someone that has caused you heartache, and you're going to be very, very defensive over this person. It could be a fire sign, Aries, Sagittarius, or Leo. You do have Swords here though, which is air signs, and you also have Pentacles, which is an earth sign. So regardless of the sign, this is a person that perhaps has caused you a bit of drama, strife, pain, you know, uncertainty, division, etc. So this Three of Swords may be coming around, or you may be very conflicted because you have a lot of choices around you. You may be torn between two people, as I mentioned, or you may be torn between a job and a relationship, and it's either, you know, you can't have one without the other this month. That's how I feel. So I feel it's about perfecting this juggling act that you have going on here, and, you know, prioritizing whatever it is that you need to. It's all about crossing paths though. Swords, you see how they're crossing over with the heart? You may cross paths with someone that will end up being really, really special to you. Could be one of these people as well. So Three of Swords in a work situation, that could be a work romance. There could also be conflict or drama at work. that might cause you a bit of stress, anxiety. Could be this juggling act, as I said, you might have to take on more than you can chew. And as a result, you know, you just feel like you might need a holiday at the end of it. You also have the seven of wands. The seven of wands is being defensive, gossip, competition, protecting yourself, needing to protect yourself, your work, your position, protect your heart. If this is in a love situation, I feel as though you're going to be defensive about letting someone new in, and maybe that's why you're doing this juggling act, because you're sort of going through and seeing which one would be better for me, which one would be more suitable. If this is in a work situation, I feel as though there could be something could come up where you might have to protect yourself. This could be because someone said something and then they, you know, tell someone else. And you need to cover yourself. You sort of need to, or you might take sudden time off work or leave early and you need to cover yourself. This is how I feel, because there could be someone around you that might cause a bit of drama and throw you under the bus. It's a possibility. It won't happen to all of you, but there's a possibility it might happen to some of you. So this is why. Also, protecting yourself. If you have a creative pursuit that you're sending out to the world, working on a book, a manuscript, a TV show, you know, anything that you're creating, a brand, a designer, you know, a logo, graphic design, you know, I feel like you need to protect this, because there might be someone out there that's going to use it against your, you know, without your permission, without you authorizing use. So make sure you copyright and you protect yourself in this type of way. I also feel like you might be defensive over something, you know, someone will say, whether it's a family member, or someone might communicate something to you, or might say or critique you on something, and you're going to be very, you're going to jump to, you know, your defense over this. Now, moving on, Capricorn, you have the Ten of Swords. Now, the Ten of Swords is a period of stagnancy. If you've been stagnant in a relationship, I feel as though the darkness is lifting and there's a new dawn on the horizon. So with the Ten, it is the end of something, but it's also the beginning of something. So with every end comes a new beginning. It's a cycle of life. It's a constant rebirth. It's change. You know, every ending is a new beginning. So I feel like you might be putting an end to a relationship and welcoming in a new one, or you might be welcoming in a new dynamic to a relationship. There could have been a period of stagnancy and that's about to change, or you might have been living with a lot of pain and hurt and conflict, and that's about to change here with the Ten of Swords. You know, the darkness is lifting. You will come out of this, Capricorn. You will be fine. You will come out on top. There's a new dawn in the horizon. There's a new day that's coming in. There's a new journey here for you. You've got the number 10, Roman numeral comes down to a number 1. This is a brand new start and it's looking promising. This is also in, if it's in a work situation with the Ten of Swords, I feel as though the Ten of Swords is talking about maybe overworking yourself, maybe needing to take a break. It's also the start of something new, entering into a new world, into a new branch, into a new role, into a new division. So this is certainly possible. You're going to hear news of this. There may even be several offers available at the same time, and you might be conflicted about which one to apply for. Someone might even critique you and say you're not qualified for this position, but I don't think that's going to stop you, Capricorn. I think you're just going to keep pursuing it. And, you know, I love to see that sort of resilience and, you know, you being really relentless. So there is, you know, that period of stagnancy is shifting. So if your business has been stagnant, has been slow, things are taking a turn for the better. Okay, you might be thinking about ways you can improve the business. You might be looking at what sort of finances you can end up spending, or, you know, how much it's going to cost you to expand or improve on the business. So this is something you could be analyzing. This is a juggling act here with the Two of Pentacles. This is juggling finances. There could be a lot of clients around you that you're going to have to juggle at the same time, a lot of big cases, depending on, you know, what your job is, what your business is, what your creative pursuit is. But the Two of Pentacles really is this juggling act. And that's why I think you'll be fine. I think, you know, there may be periods where it's stagnant, or periods where you really jump to your defense, or periods that are really busy. But I feel for the most part, you're going to manage just fine with the juggling act. This could also be an opportunity to travel, because you have boats here, you've got new lands, and you've got the World card. So there could be an opportunity to travel. You could meet someone on travels. You could be separated by someone by geographical distance. You could also be thinking about which location to go to as well. You could be torn between which locations to visit or in your country or anywhere in the world. So you could be a bit torn about that. But this could be romantic as well. You could be juggling two different relationships, and perhaps it's because you just, work is so demanding that you're just going to have to, just juggle a lot of things. But I feel it's going to open up new doors for you. Whatever it is that you're juggling, I feel there's going to be a brand new opportunity that's going to present itself. I love the World card. It's one of my favorite in the deck. It's anything is possible. All bets are off. The universe is here. It's fate. It's a new world is opening up. A new world is being created. It's travel. It's seeing the world. It's embracing cultures, embracing everything that the world and this life has to offer. So this is how I feel. Like, despite hurdles and hardships and pains and all this, hard work, something really good will come of it, Capricorn. So stay, be relentless, stay relentless, because something really good is going to come to you. It's going to, a new world is going to take shape here. So whether you've been hurt in the past and you're scared about opening yourself up again, whether you've been stagnant in career and you haven't received the salary you want, there might be two offers that, or counter offers that will be made, that will be presented to you, and as a result, it's going to open up a new opportunity. It's going to open up new doors for you. Here with the World card, there's a large foreign influence here. Some of you might be working on a visa. You're going to hear news about the outcome of a visa, of a citizenship, of an immigration outcome, a verdict, an approval of some kind. Something you've been working on for quite some time. Some of you might be applying for a course or studies overseas as well. You might be conflicted as to which university or which college to apply for. This could be travel as well. This could be that you could experience a heartbreak on travels as well. Or someone with a foreign influence is going to be very, very prominent around you, Capricorn. If it's not you, then it's someone that's around you and is going to weigh heavily. And it's almost like this feeling to go or not to go to visit them, maybe. But for the most part, I feel like it's just, there's a lot of choices. And there's a lot of juggling, and you're going to be torn between places, people, jobs, services, clients, products. Don't let that weigh too heavily on you. I really think, you'll have the better judgment. You'll know the outcome. I feel like you'll know it's a good outcome, but I feel, your judgment might be a little bit clouded, but I feel for the most part, you need to stay strong, because the darkness, as I said, is lifting, and this will change. If it's been a hard relationship and there's been a lot of drama and there's been a third party involved, this is going to shift, and you've been really defensive. I feel as though a new world is opening up, or you might be torn between the decision whether to stay or to go, or whether this is in a creative pursuit or a business. There's been drama and gossip and correspondence and a lot of things that have been placed on your shoulders, and it's weighing heavy. Maybe it's a decision. You need to ask for more money. You need to leave. This could be make or break as well here for you, Capricorn. But I love that you have the World card here. Absolutely love. This is things coming to a culmination, things coming to fruition. A new world is opening up. New doors will be opening up because of everything that you've done here, because of the choices you'll make, because of the juggling act, because of the communication, because of the correspondence, because of coming out of this stagnancy. There will be, wonderful new opportunities, but you need to stay strong, you need to stay committed, and you need to stay, be resilient. So, but I hope this has been insightful for you.